Thanks for having us to dinner, Mrs. Griffin.
Oh, my pleasure, Pam.
Yes, I, for one, say this is long overdue. It's about time people of color broke bread at this table.
Broke bread? What were you, St. Francis of Assisi all of a sudden?
Jerome, you have done a wonderful job raising Pam to be a lovely young woman.
You say that like you're surprised.
I beg your pardon?
Sounds like you're saying a single black man can't raise a child on his own.
Yes, Lois, what are you saying? You know, before I speak, I like to ask myself, would Dr. King approve of what I'm about to say? Most of the time, I find that he would.
Dad, I think Mrs. Griffin was just giving you a compliment.
Yeah, I was just trying to say we all appreciate having you in our home.
Oh, so suddenly we're all friends.
We've always been friends.
If we're friends, what's my last name?
Cool J.
Where am I from?
The south part of a large city.
Where'd I go to college?
Does it air commercials during daytime judge programs?
Peter, you only got two of those three things right. Look, I know what this is about. You're being all nice just so your son can get into my daughter's pants.
Dad, stop it.
White guys don't want a relationship with black women. They just want a notch on their belt. You're a novelty to these people.
These people? This is the moment in the meal when I stand up.
Wait a minute. A novelty? We used to date before I met Peter. So what are white women to black men?
A very pleasant page in our memory books.
Aw.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You banged my wife.
She did? No wonder I had so much room in there. Her womb was like one of those places where they reconstruct crashed airplanes.
Well, Jerome, I know you think we're all terrible, but white people have done a lot of good things for the world.
Oh, yeah? Like what?
Well, I'll tell you. Listen up.
You know what? That song only made me hate white people even more.
What about eight more verses?
Let's go, Pam. We're leaving.
But, Dad, Chris treats me really well. He gave me this diamond necklace.
That's my diamond necklace.
Cool it. I'm trying to get laid.
Look, this ain't happening, Pam. Straight up. You ain't swerving with him. You ain't gonna shuck a jump. You're not hollering at him. You ain't his shorty or his boo.
Oh, my God, Lois. I think he just summoned Candyman.
You're a fool.
God, I miss Pam so much. I don't think I can live without her.
It's okay, Chris. Hey, here's someone your type. Woo-wee, Chris. You're cute.
Stewie, that's Log Cabin.
He gets the joke.
I'm sorry, Chris. Jerome just doesn't think his daughter should date a white guy.
Black racism is the biggest problem facing this country today.
You know, I should go over there and fight for Pam.
Absolutely you should. You should always fight for what you believe in, like Patrick Henry.
Give me liberty or give me death.
Oh, that was easy.
I know, right? Ryan wanted to give him liberty. You do the paperwork, Ryan.
And now, the HBO original series, Boys.
Hey, sorry I slept with that girl you liked.
That's cool. Did you walk around naked after you had sex?
What? No. No one wants to see that.
Isn't this time in our lives so interesting?
No.
Griffin, where the hell is my daughter? She left me a note saying she ran off with Chris.
Oh my God, Chris? That dirtbag hangs around my daughter too.
I don't have time for your nonsense. I gotta find my daughter.
Look, let me help you. I'm great at finding stuff. Last night I found Lois's G-spot.
No, I didn't.
I didn't know she was home. I was able to please her in other ways, though.
No.
Okay, let's just go.
My dad's such a jerk. I'm glad we ran away.
Yeah. So, what do people do in motels?
They get naked.
Okay, but all I know about sex is from internet porn, so I am very excited to try Buffering.
Then I'll leave you alone to get undressed and under the covers, and I'll be right back.
Thank you, pretty lady.
So all those other black drivers that you're nodding at, do you know them?
Man.
Look, relax. We'll just tell him the truth. We're cruising around town looking for a sexually active 14-year-old boy.
You have any idea how fast you were going?
I was going the speed limit, officer.
He was.
Are you here against your will, sir?
If you're asking if I'd rather be at the zoo, then yes.
Maybe you step out of the car and we see if you've been drinking.
I'm too fat to be in the car by myself.
Police pull me over for major violations all the time. You don't know what it's like to be treated like a criminal.
What's it like?
Bad.
Whoa.
I've never broken the law in my life, Peter. I'm a 42-year-old man. I own a business, I pay my taxes, and yet I gotta deal with this crap every time I step outside my house. It makes me so damn angry, I don't know what to do with myself.
Well, you should be like me. Whenever I get angry, I go do some Footloose dancing.
Peter, you seem like a nice guy. I don't mind having you in my bar, man. But it's different when it's your baby girl.
I guess. I just have boys.
Forgive me for being a protective father, but white people have exploited and mistreated blacks for centuries, and I'm not gonna let that happen to Pam.
Wow.